We've taken six of the world's top athletes to find out what it takes to make a true Olympian.
Come on, Wiggin, come on.
Testing, analyzing.
15, come on.
Going behind the stats of an elite athlete as we push their bodies to the max.
Slopestyle snowboards, and it's a very new event to the Olympic program. But it's actually now progressed into a highly competitive Olympic sport. Because to some extent, what they are is they're acrobats. The power to weight ratio is very important because that's what's going to give us the height of jump. That's what's going to get those critical extra points.
Sven Thorgren is one of the world's leading slopestyle riders. At the 2014 Olympic Winter Games in Sochi, Russia, he placed fourth. He's pushing hard for the podium next time and is training year-round to stay at the top of his game.
And I feel like the more I snowboard, the more addictive I get to it. It could be any day, it could be the worst weather day ever, and I still can have as much fun as I ever had before. And it's not about one single time or one single trick, it's about the whole riding experience.
We've brought Sven to one of the world's leading human performance labs to test his speed, strength, and endurance as we push him to the limit. We're hoping to discover what makes his anatomy stand out from the crowd and what he needs to do to rise to the top of his sport. On the surface, Sven looks like the typical snowboarder, young, compact, and light. But what's the story behind his stats? Time to let our sports scientist loose on Sven.
I mean, actually, what we're going to look at is your body composition. And what I mean by that is, what is lean tissue, so essentially muscle, and what is fatty tissue, which is fat, essentially. Okay.
See how fat I am.
See how fat you are, yeah, basically. See how fat you are.
A DEXA scan allows us to see just how lean and streamlined Sven really is. Fat stores energy and provides insulation, but for an Olympic athlete, it's muscle that makes all the difference. A typical alpine skier has a body fat composition of just below 16%. An ice hockey player is leaner still at 10.5%. But Sven's sleek physique is made up of just 10% body fat, the same as a 100-meter sprinter.
Sven's DEXA results, for me, are really interesting. I think, to some extent, what they do is they dispel that myth of what snowboarders are. I mean, what we have is an incredibly lean, truly elite athlete. He's got a body fat percentage of 10%. That's right at the very bottom end of the spectrum. He is a big air guy, you know, he's a big jump man. So to be very low in body fat and very high in power and strength is absolutely crucial. And Sven has got that in bundles.
Yeah, I mean, from the beginning, it was all about just snowboarding as much as he could, and he got strong from that. But lately, with like the Olympics and everything, you get more serious. It's a young sport, so we kind of realize that now that you have to be really strong to do what we do.
This test is really a test of speed, but underlying that speed, it's about strength and power, and it's about strength and power of the lower body. So this is all about Sven. This is exactly what he does. The expectation is he should be fast, he should be powerful, and he should be strong.
In slopestyle, riders have to go from a standing start to full throttle in a fraction of a second. Hamstrings, calf muscles, hip flexors, and quadriceps combining to generate the explosive power they need to truly excel.
Let's really go for it. Let's get your best time. When you're ready.
Go on, Sven, all the way through. Through the top gate, through the top gate. Good lad, well done. Good work. Good job.
Sven is measured over 5 and 20 meter intervals, recording both his raw speed and his contact time. Slopestyle demands both speed and strength, as riders must convert the power from their takeoff into as much height as they can to execute their tricks. Our slopestyle rider certainly looks quick, but how does Sven's results stack up?
Your fastest time was 3.01 seconds for 20 meters.
Sven's rapid acceleration outpaces some of the fastest professional football and rugby players on the planet. and his ground contact time is nothing short of breathtaking, enabling him to transition from a static start to full slopestyle speed in less time than it takes for the human eye to blink.
What we see with Sven is an incredible power output. In other words, as his foot hits the ground, it leaves the ground very, very quickly, which really is valuable for him when it comes to those aerials, which we know he's so good at.
When I was 7, I wanted to try snowboarding. We had like a small hill because I grew up outside Stockholm, and we had like this really tiny hill. I went there every night after school. All from that point, it kind of clicked for me, and I think when I was 14, I was like traveling the world and getting paid for snowboarding, which is kind of crazy for a 14-year-old. Going to Sochi in 2014 was all around like a great experience because I never had a goal like that. I mean, I had big contests like X Games and stuff, but in the end, when I did the Olympics, I did the exact run that I wanted to do and everything worked out as planned. And then I got a fourth place. But yeah, it was a great experience.
For Sven, the force test will provide vital data on the key muscle groups he must work on to really push for medals. Jump height needs power production. Has Sven got what it takes to be up with the best?
This really is what his event is about when it comes to aerials. This is about jump height. It is about control. It is about power.
Essentially, what we're going to get you to do is jump as high as you possibly can.
And that's probably even more relevant to what I'm actually doing on the snowboard, like popping off a jump or something.
Exactly that. Okay, if you want to start the test, Josh, we're going to go 3, 2, 1, jump!
By measuring the force Sven exerts on the highly sensitive plate, when he jumps from standing, we can calculate just how much vertical height he can generate. In slopestyle, the ramps or kickers help propel riders over 30 meters in height. So if Sven wants to medal, he needs to produce maximum power output.
Hit and then bounce back up. And we'll go in 3, 2, 1, drop. That's it. That's the one. Perfect.
On an Olympic slopestyle course, riders can spend as much as 3 seconds in the air. The longer they're airborne, the more time to impress the judges.
Good.
Analyzing the data from Sven's drop jump shows us his flight time results put him among the best in his sport. Good to know when getting big air is so vital to generating an elite performance. But it's in vertical height that Sven really excels, showing just how efficient he is at producing maximum power for the takeoff phase.
I mean, that is an incredible counter movement jump from Sven. 45.72 centimeters, that is a long way to jump up. And to put that into context, that's what we expect to see from volleyball players and basketball players. He's equal or greater than many of the other athletes that we see, particularly team game athletes like rugby players and football players. He is well beyond those.
I kind of expected me to be kind of good at this because it's something I do a lot.
Yeah, I think that's definitely reflected in the result. And you jumped 45.7 centimeters, which is really pretty impressive.
For athletes, the ability to take in the maximum amount of oxygen and deliver it to where it is needed most is vital to peak performance. But how will a non-endurance specialist like Sven measure up in this extreme test of stamina?
Well, Sven's just about to do an aerobic capacity test, that classic VO2 max test.
I'm sure you've probably heard of them. I'm sure you've probably done them at some point in your career.
I've done it. It's pretty harsh.
And it really tells us about that endurability, the heart, the lungs, the blood, the muscle.
So I'm going to start off and bite it, a little bit of blood out your finger. So
we're also measuring Sven's blood lactate levels to determine how quickly he can recover from maximum effort to enable him to perform at the most efficient level possible.
Let's do it.
Every 60 seconds, the speed and incline of the treadmill is increased to continually test Sven's endurance. Greater aerobic performance means he can train longer and harder, and when he competes, he will be functioning in the peak area of performance.
Increase, good job. So I think you've got a bit in you there, though. Keep yourself pushing. 16 and 6 now. Good, Sven. Come on, you've got this. Keep pushing now.
Keep pushing everything you've got. Now we're working. Come on.
For Sven to be in that zone of optimum effort, he has to be functioning at his most efficient, traveling at up to 80 kilometers an hour, taking jumps the equivalent of leaping from a 9-story building, and reacting to sudden changes of velocity and direction demands elite-level responses.
Go on, keep pushing everything you've got. Now we're working. Come on.
Good job. Go on, keep driving those legs. Drive, drive, drive. This is good. Everything you've got. Nice job.
Well done, well done. No, that's perfect. Well done. Great job. Well done.
You always feel like you could give that last shot.
I mean, to put it in one word, amazing. VO2 max of Sven, 65 millilitres per kilogram per minute. It really is exceptional. And it puts him right in the midst of some of the most elite team sports players, which is surprising.
Sven's endurance is a real surprise. His VO2 max levels would even earn him a place in an Olympic rowing crew where stamina is essential. Combined with his blood lactate metrics, there is clearly much more to this rider than just his speed and strength.
Interestingly, when you take a look at his blood lactate results, what you see is very high values. And those very high values actually indicate a massive anaerobic capacity. And that tells me one of two things, really. Number one is he's got a fantastic engine underneath the bonnet. But I think what it also demonstrates is that truly elite athletes have an incredible global conditioning, even in areas that aren't necessarily specialist to their performance.
Go, 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 go!
We've pushed Sven to his maximum, testing every area of his physiology and driving him to the limits of his endurance. His explosive power and raw speed make him ideally suited to excel at his sport. But it's his remarkable aerobic strength that makes him truly stand out among his fellow elite riders. It's this anatomical edge that just might be the difference between a place and a podium finish at the next Winter Olympic Games.
I think people kind of underestimate snowboarders because they see us as kids that just have fun and go out there and go home and party, but there's a lot of work behind it, and I think most snowboarders are really strong and healthy.
I mean, Sven really, for me, demonstrates where slopestyle snowboard has come from, the migration towards the truly elite, truly professional athlete. To be an Olympian, not only do you have to be elite amongst the population, you have to be elite amongst your peers. And I think what Sven demonstrates really very well is that he's got everything that you would expect him to have and more.